Good day, my name is Mark Malore. I'm the principal of the Malore Law Firm here. We specialize primarily in real estate construction and foreclosure litigation. I want to speak with you today briefly about some of the pitfalls in foreclosure litigation and what you face as a deed of trust holder, whether you're first or second on the property, so you can ensure that you handle the foreclosure correctly and avoid some of the pitfalls that my other clients in Corona recently had. So what do my Corona lien holder clients encounter when they want to foreclose on a piece of property? Well, particularly they encounter the process, which is non-judicial, primarily in California. We have both judicial and non-judicial in California, but 98% of foreclosures in California now go by way of non-judicial foreclosure, which simply put is the recording of a notice of default after the default and payment, 2 or 3 months, recording notice of sale, and then selling the property on the courthouse steps. Now what transpires? Well, if you don't do that process correctly, or you don't have the proper wording in your notice of default that's being recorded, or your notice of sale that's being recorded, or you don't mail them correctly to the homeowner, those things can unwind your foreclosure sale faster than you can say foreclosure sale. Part of the problem is that the foreclosure statutes in California are very specific and very particularized. So they need to be followed to the letter of the law. And if they're not, it's very easy for a judge to overturn them because the particulars aren't dealt with. These clients I mentioned recently in Corona that I had came to me after they tried to hold a foreclosure sale on their own. And they had a particular industrial piece of property that also had a second encumbering the property. The second filed a lawsuit against my clients because they had allegedly done an improper foreclosure process, meaning their notice of default wasn't recorded correctly, didn't have the proper requirements in the notice of default as required by California statute, didn't record the notice of sale properly, and weren't about to hold the foreclosure sale. Because of their lawsuit and the injunction that the court issued, it stopped the foreclosure dead in its tracks. My clients were unable to seize the property and resell it, missing a buying opportunity and some of the equity that they could have gained by doing so. So why do I tell you all that? Because you need to make sure that those particulars are followed correctly. With a notice of default after 2 or 3 late payments, you have to let 90 days transpire before you can record the notice of sale. And then once the notice of sale is recorded, you have to let 20 days transpire before you can hold the sale on the courthouse steps, if you will, or sell the property for the encumbrance against it or to a third party. Some of those are very simplistic issues, but very specialized and important issues when it comes to enforcing your foreclosure rights on a particular piece of property. Here at the Malore Law Firm, we specialize in foreclosure litigation and handling foreclosures for private equity owners on a particular piece of property, and we of course would be happy to help assist you there in Corona if you have any particular issues that you'd like to discuss. Feel free to contact us, and look forward to hearing from you. Hopefully that information is helpful.